Hi dear students, welcome back to our video lecturing. In our last class, we studied about the histology of alimentary canal as well as the modification from the mucosa of our alimentary canal. Next, in this session, we are going to learn about the different types of digestive glands in our digestive system. So next is the digestive glands. Let's see, what are the digestive glands in our digestive system? See, we have three types of digestive glands. These digestive glands are of three types. So there are total three types of digestive glands in our digestive system. They are, first one, accessory digestive glands. First is accessory digestive glands. Accessory digestive glands. Or associated glands. Accessory digestive glands or associated glands. So the accessory or associated digestive gland. Second one, mucosal glands. Second digestive glands are mucosal glands. Third one, submucosal glands. These are the three types of digestive glands in our digestive system. Accessory, mucosal and submucosal glands. Here, the accessory digestive glands includes, that means the glands in associated with our alimentary canal. The accessory digestive glands are, first one, salivary glands. Accessory digestive glands include, first is salivary glands, second one liver, and third one pancreas. These are the accessory digestive glands. Accessory or associated digestive glands are salivary glands, liver and pancreas. Then mucosal digestive glands are, that means the digestive glands formed from the mucosa of our alimentary canal. The glands modified from the mucosa of our alimentary canal are gastric glands and crypts of Leverkin. Gastric glands and crypts of Leverkin. These are the mucosa modified digestive glands. Last one, submucosal gland. It is Brunner. Brunner's gland. In the submucosa of duodenum, Brunner's gland from the submucosa of duodenum. So Brunner's gland from the submucosa of duodenum. These are the three types of digestive glands in our digestive system. So there are total three types of digestive gland: accessory, mucosal and submucosal. Accessory are salivary glands, liver and pancreas. Mucosal are gastric glands and crypts of Leverkin. Submucosal are Brunner's gland. Okay. So let's study these digestive glands in detail. First one is salivary gland. Salivary glands. These salivary glands are associated digestive glands. It is in associated with the oral cavity. It is an associated digestive gland. Salivary gland. We have three pairs of salivary glands in our oral cavity. Three pairs of salivary glands. So we have three pairs of salivary glands in our oral cavity. They are, first one, let's see the location and types. We have three pairs. See, suppose this is the oral cavities here. This is the oral cavity. See, these salivary glands are seen associated with the oral cavity. I told you we have three pairs of salivary glands. They are, this is first pair. This is a pair of salivary gland. This is another one. And third one is here. So we have three pairs of salivary gland. Three pairs of salivary glands in our oral cavity. Let's see, what are the three pairs of salivary gland? These three pairs of salivary glands include, first type, first one is a pair of peri- first pair is parotid gland. Parotid glands are the largest salivary gland. The largest salivary glands are parotid. It is the largest salivary gland. Location. They are seen associated with the cheek. These parotid glands are associated with the cheek. It is associated with the cheek below the ear. It is associated with the cheek below the ear, the parotid. So largest salivary gland, it is associated with the cheek below the ear. Then its duct is called, its duct of this parotid gland. See, through the duct, their secretions releases to the vestibular region or to the oral cavity. So its duct is called, duct of parotid gland is called as Stenson's duct. Through this Stenson's duct, their secretion releases to the oral cavity. Then, the paramyxoviral infection. The paramyxoviral infection of parotid gland is called as mumps. It is a paramyxoviral infection, causes the edema or swelling of parotid gland. It is called as mumps. The paramyxoviral infection of salivary gland. You see, particularly the parotid gland. Then second pair. Second pair is sublingual gland. Sublingual glands. Second pair of salivary glands are sublingual glands. These are the smallest salivary gland. Largest is parotid. Smallest salivary gland is sublingual. It is located below the tongue. So location, they are seen below the tongue. It is located just below the tongue. And see, it is sublingual. Then, its duct is called, its duct is called as duct of Ravinus. Its duct is called as duct of Ravinus. It's the duct of this parotid gland. Sorry, sublingual gland. Then third one, third pair of salivary gland is submaxillary. Submaxillary glands. Submaxillary glands. Or it is also called as submandibular glands. Submaxillary or submandibular glands. Submaxillary or submandibular gland. Seen on the cornice of lower jaw. Seen on the cornice of lower jaw. So they are seen on the cornice of lower jaw. This submaxillary or sublingual gland. Its duct is called as Wharton's duct. Its duct is Wharton's duct. These are the three pairs of salivary glands in our oral cavity. Parotid, sublingual, submaxillary or submandibular. And this parotid is the largest salivary gland. Sublingual is the smallest salivary gland. These are the three pairs of salivary glands. Okay. Then, all the three pairs of salivary glands secrete saliva. So secretions of all these three pairs of salivary glands are called as saliva. So the secretions of three pairs of salivary glands in our oral cavity, it is saliva. Let's see what are the components of saliva. So let's study the components of saliva. Components of saliva. See, saliva contains, first one, it contains water. That means 99% of saliva is water. 99% of saliva is water. Second, it contains mucus. Saliva contains mucus. Third one, it contains electrolytes. It contains electrolytes like sodium, potassium, chloride, bicarbonate, etc. are the electrolytes of saliva. So it contains electrolytes. Next, it contains the antibody. saliva contains the antibody IgA. Immunoglobulin A, the IgA antibody found in saliva. Next, it contains the antimicrobial agent. It contains the antimicrobial agents like thiocyanate. It contains the antimicrobial agents like thiocyanate ion. Then another component of saliva, saliva contains enzymes. Enzymes are present in saliva. Let's see what are the enzymes in saliva. Saliva contains enzymes like, first one is salivary amylase. Salivary amylase or ptyalin. Salivary amylase or ptyalin is a carbohydrate digesting enzyme. That means its function is hydrolysis of polysaccharides to disaccharide. Its function is hydrolysis of polysaccharide to disaccharide. This carbohydrate digesting enzyme in saliva called as salivary amylase or ptyalin is a carbohydrate digesting enzyme. And its optimum pH. Every enzyme action required optimum pH and optimum temperature. The optimum pH for salivary amylase enzyme is 6.8. Is the optimum pH for the enzyme salivary amylase. Then another component of this. So another enzyme of saliva is, it is lysozyme. Saliva contains lysozyme. This lysozyme is an antibacterial agent. Lysozyme is an antibacterial agent in saliva. Okay. So what are the antimicrobial agents in saliva? Antimicrobial agents in saliva. What are the antimicrobial agents? The antimicrobial agents in saliva are the immunoglobulin A, then thiocyanate ion, and lysozyme. These are the antibacterial or antimicrobial agents in saliva. IgA, immunoglobulin A is the antibody, then thiocyanate ion and lysozyme. These are the antimicrobial agents in saliva. That's all about salivary glands and their secretion. Okay.